praise. In Jesus' name we pray and amen. Amen. Park Avenue, what is our mission? Our mission is to share the transformative and liberating gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. So today we're come to praise and to magnify the Lord. The choir is going to come to you today with our praise and worship and with a choir selection. I strongly encourage you today to not sit back. I strongly encourage you today to not look upon us like we don't know what we're doing. I strongly encourage you today to praise him. I strongly encourage you today to lift him. I promise you, if you praise him, he'll touch you. If you praise him, he'll come through for you. Help us magnify the name of the Lord.
Thought I was worth saving, so you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for, so you sacrificed your life. So I can be free, so I can be whole, so I can tell everyone I know. So you came. Because I am,
How many of your mind is fixed? How many of your heart is fixed and your mind is made up? Come on, let me see your hand. Good God Almighty. We're in for a good time on today. We're ready for our announcements. And our announcements are as follows. First of all, on Tuesday, April 9th, 2024, at 7 p.m., will be our youth choir rehearsal right here in our sanctuary. Parents, please bring your children out, the youth out. Most of them don't have a driver's license as yet. And so we are depending on you to bring them out. Amen. April 8th through the 10th and April 12th, 2024, 6:30 p.m. nightly, Union District Missionary Baptist Association spring session will convene at Rescue Missionary Baptist Church, 2901 Indiana, Kansas City, Missouri, 64128. Our host pastor is Pastor W.T. Bland. Pastor Floyd Sullivan is our moderator. Please mark your calendars and govern yourselves accordingly. Also on Saturday, April 20th, 2024, at 12 noon, will be a mandatory. It's all in caps. It's all bolded. Mandatory leaders meeting right here in Park Avenue. Amen. That means all leaders. If you're in a leadership position, pastor is asking for you to be here Saturday, April 20th at 12 noon. Please mark your calendars and govern yourselves accordingly. Also on Wednesday, April 24th, 2024 is Administrative Professionals Day. Let us remember. There's one person that comes to my mind right now. I work in the corporate world, so I know administrative assistants. But there's one person that comes to my mind that I think we ought to give a round of applause right now. That is Adela Thomas. Woo-hoo! Yeah, yeah. That's right, Chris. That's right, Chris. That's how you do it. He stood up for his wife. Amen. Then also Saturday, April 27th, 2024, at 12 noon, will be for men only. This is a session for all men, not just men of Park Avenue, but for men, period. Young men, old men, middle-aged men, all men come together. The Bible says iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens the wits of another. Let us come together, brothers. We have some pains and some hurts and some things that we go through that we can share with one another if we allow ourselves to open up. Amen. Open up. I can't be your friend if I don't know you. Amen? Right. You can't be my friend if you don't know me. Amen? So let's come together under the tutelage and the teaching instruction of Minister Derek Dean. We will come together as men and we will discuss things that are comparable to us as men. Amen? Again, that is Saturday, April 27th, 2024, at 12 noon, right here at Park Avenue. Invite somebody, brothers. Invite somebody. Bring somebody with you. Then also, Sunday, April 28th, 2024, is our Mother's Ministry Annual Day. I'm not aware of the assessment amount, but please make sure that you bring something special to give for our mother's ministry. Our mother's ministry have been here a long time. They've taught us. They've raised us. They showed us the way. They pray for us. Amen? Amen. So let us make sure that we bring something. I'm not sure what the assessment is, and we may make that announcement later, but right now I want you to prepare yourselves, if you will, to bring something special for the mother's ministry. Amen? Amen. Then on Saturday, April 18th, 2024. There will be a leadership conference held at the Oak Grove, held at Oak Grove Missionary Baptist Church, 4545 Benton Boulevard, Kansas City, Missouri. Special guest will be Dr. Kerwin B. Lee. And if you have not sat under his tutelage, if you haven't heard him preach, if you haven't heard him teach, then you want to do this before you make your way to heaven. Amen? This man is a dynamic teacher. He has a way of putting together comical as well as biblical fact-based information that is entertaining and also, what am I trying to say? It's also
Relevant.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Entertaining and relevant. Amen. So please, please mark your calendar. May 18, 2024. This is a leadership conference for everyone. This is a free community event, and it includes three leadership courses. Breakfast and lunch will be provided. It's hosted by Pastor Kim Gladney of the Oak Grove Baptist Church and our own pastor, Pastor Gregory Stevens of Park Avenue Missionary Baptist Church. That means if it's being hosted by our pastor, what that mean? That means we need to be there, right? Amen. Amen. Let's be there. Let's be there in good attendance. There is a flyer that is in the foyer right now. You can pick up one of these flyers. There'll be a sign-up sheet out there. If you don't have an opportunity or don't want to stand in the line for the sign-up, there is a QR code on the flyer. If you pick up one of the flyers, you can register right from your phone. To make it a little more convenient for you if you don't want to stand in the line and sign up out there. But there is a sign-up sheet. Again, this is May 18, 2024, Leadership Conference at Oak Grove Missionary Baptist Church with a special guest, Dr. Kerwin B. Lee. Amen. The last announcement is Women in Prayer will resume on May 25th, 2024 at 12 noon. This is led by our very own First Lady, Sister Carmelita Stevens. Come on, give her a round of applause. Amen. Amen. These are your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. We are now ready for, as is our tradition, to receive communion. Amen. As we prepare our hearts,
the blood had she. Valley. that gives me strength from day to day. It will never lose his It will never, ever, ever lose. It will never, ever lose its power. The same blood that flows from its veins. It took my filthy black soul and washed it white as snow. It will never lose. Never ever lose its power. It will never, 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 ever, ever, never, ever, ever, never, ever, ever, never, never, never.
Never lose the power. Receive the Lord's communion. Never loses power. I just want to publicly say thank you. Thank you to Nikki Taylor for letting God use you. You always stir my heart. And that's real. We are ready to receive communion at this time. In the pew in front of you should be enough communion offerings. If you don't have one, we're going to ask that you hold up your hand. Our deacons are going to come right now, and they're going to pass out to those in the rear, and also make sure the preachers get communion as well. Let us receive our offering. I'm going to read a scripture beginning at 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, beginning at the 23rd verse. It reads as follows: For I've received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After the same manner, also he took the cup. When he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup, for he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation unto himself, not discerning the Lord's body. Amen. Go ahead. Hey, I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. Go ahead, get him in the back. Blood came streaming down for me. Come on, y'all. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. I know it was. How many of y'all know it was the blood? I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. They have it. Has anyone been omitted? Anyone been omitted? Everyone receive communion. Amen. Let us pause a moment, examine ourselves, present ourselves unto the Lord, and then we'll eat and drink together. Let's have a moment of silence. Amen. For some, it may take longer than others. Let us eat and drink together. For those of you in the pews, place your cups in the pew in front of you. Others, our deacons will come by and pick them up. At this time, we want to prepare our hearts for prayer. It is prayer time. There's a lot going on in our world, a lot going on in our neighborhood, for that matter. Maybe a lot going on in your own family. But we want to be in prayer because we know that God can do anything but fail. Am I right about it, somebody? Right. Amen. In our lesson today, Minister Dean taught us that friends ought to come together and lift each other up unto the Lord. Amen? Amen? Amen. So let's do that in our prayer today. There may be somebody, a person, place, or a situation that you know that stands in the need of God's intervention. Make sure you present those things, those elements, those people unto the Lord this morning. Pray for our pastor. He is fastly recovering. Amen? Let's say amen for that. Amen. Amen. He told me that he's a little bit more comfortable, and I praise God for that. And he will be back very soon. Soon and very soon, we are going to see our pastor. Oh, that ain't how that go. Amen. We want to pray for one another. I'm going to ask that Minister Derek Dean will come and lead us in an open and a corporate prayer. Amen. If you want to join us at the altar, please make your way to the altar.
Anyone else that wants to come for prayer? Mm-hmm. Oh, my brother, pray for me. For when you bow. Y'all can go ahead and spread on the cross. Way down at the altar, please don't forget. Pray for me. Father, today we thank you, first of all, for your outstretched hand of mercy. You told us in your word that every morning is brand new mercies. So, Lord, we thank you for brand new mercies, for brand new messes. Thank you that your power and your blood is still efficacious to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Thank you, Lord, for taking away the yoke of addiction and taking away the yokes off of our mind, the bondage of sin. God, in making us your people, thank you, Lord, that we are your sons and your daughters. Thank you, Lord, as the Bible says, that we are not bastards, but we are legitimate children. So, Father, today we come to you this morning, God, with all sorts of needs, with all sorts of problems. Some are financial, some are emotional, some are relational. God, there are all kinds of issues around this altar. But you told us in your word, Lord, that if we have an issue, we could come and just ask you about it. You told us to ask and it shall be given. We ain't got to beg you. We can just simply ask of you. So, Lord, today we come to you based on your righteousness, not on ours. We don't have any good works. We don't have anything that's outstanding. But we come because you gave us an invitation. You told us to come before your throne to find grace to help in time of need. So, Lord, today, God, I lift up every concern around this altar. God, those men and women, God, that are struggling financially. God, some are struggling in their business. It seems like as hard as they're trying, things are just not coming together. They're not getting the opportunity. They're not getting the deal. Father, today, by the power of the Holy Spirit, Father, today, make a way for that individual. God, make a way for that individual. They're looking to you. They're believing you. Oh, God, to bring them from the bottom and put them on the top. God, make a way for them. God, you said in your word that you're able to open doors that no man can close. And you can turn around and close doors that no man can open. So, Father, today, open up a door. Make a way out of no way. Look upon that brother or sister, God, whose job is playing out and they've got notice that things are going to be ending soon. Father, you're still a way out of no way. You said that you would supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. God, it ain't got nothing to do with the job. It's because of you. You are the source. God, you move through the job, but you are the source. So, God, tonight, if one source has phased out, God, open up a brand new way in Jesus' name. God, look upon that individual, God, that is troubled in their mind, troubled in their marriage. Things are just not going well, and they're contemplating divorce or contemplating splitting. Father, today, hold that marriage together. God, let forgiveness come. Let love come. Let compassion come. Let grace come, God, in that marriage. God, for we know that love covers a multitude of faults. In Jesus' name, God, we come against the very thought of divorce. We come against the very thought of it. Father, you said in your word that you hate divorce. God, you desire that those things that you put together, God, that no man will pluck them asunder. So, Father, today, God, every other need that was not mentioned but is still on this altar, Holy Spirit, meet every need. Look upon the college student. Look upon the elementary school student, the grandmother, the grandfather, the new mother, the new father. Look upon that one that's incarcerated, God, and can't get out, and they're not able to raise their children like they would desire. But Father, today you're able to make a way out of no way. God, even in prison, you can set us free. So Father, today let every shackle, let every yoke fall off of our minds, off of our spirits, so that we can praise you in the beauty of holiness. Now, Father, you said in your word that without faith it's impossible to please you. So, Lord, today we praise you by faith. We thank you by faith that it's done. We thank you by faith that you've made a way. Thank you by faith for deliverance, for healing in Jesus' name. Thank you for salvation. You're turning that sinner around. You're breaking the yoke of addiction. God, you're taking away the taste of meth and fentanyl and marijuana. God, you're delivering right now by your spirit. You said in your word that you sent your word and you heal them. So thank you for healing the mind. Thank you for healing the spirit. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverance. In Jesus' name we pray. And for this we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you majesty and dominion and power. Come on and help me praise him. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, that you're doing it by your spirit and by your power. In Jesus' name we pray. And amen.
Giving honor to God this morning, amen. I've been given the opportunity and the pleasure to introduce our speaker on today, amen. You know, it's so much that we need to be thankful for, amen. So much, amen. We're living in the last and evil days, and all you, every day is a new day, amen. But you know what? I talk about we love to hear our musicians, we love to hear our choir, amen. But we need to love to hear God's word. Amen. So I've been given the opportunity to introduce our guest preacher for today, amen. You know, when the word go forward, amen, it's for us, amen. Living in these last and evil days, we need a word from God every day. Not just on Sunday, but every day, amen, because every day is a struggle, amen. It's a struggle to stay saved, amen, amen. It ain't easy, amen. But God's word was going to give us strength to keep going on, amen, to stand strong in these last and evil days. So without further ado, I want to introduce our guest preacher for today, and I ask y'all to open up your hearts and open up your minds to give that word, the word that he give us, that we will hide it in our heart, that we may not sin against him. Amen? Amen. So with no further ado, I'll introduce our guest speaker for today, Minister Pastor Daniel Childs. Amen. Give us a round of applause for him this morning.
I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you cared for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Come on your feet if you love him. Oh, I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you cared for me such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Oh, my heart, my mind, soul belong. You paid the price for me way back on Calvary. That's why I lift you up and I magnify you. That's why my heart is filled with prayer. Come on and give the Lord some glory in this house. Give him some glory in this house. We give honor to Pastor Stevens and his recovery. Certainly to the First Lady, Sister Stevens, my friend and brothers in the gospel, and you, the Park Avenue family. I love you. I love you, Lord. Today, amen. What a joy it is to stand in this historic church, amen. A little old raggedy boy used to run up and down 35th Street. And look what God has done. I need your attention to Acts chapter 4. I think I'm going to do verses 13 through 20. Acts chapter 4. Verses 13 through 20. Certainly we are praying for your pastor. He is the first vice president of our ministers union. And you know or may not know, but when Reverend Payne passed away, Reverend Stevens completed that tenure and started all the way back over and earned his own tenure. And not many brothers would do that. Amen. Some folks' ego wouldn't let them go from top to. You don't have to say amen. I know it. So we thank God for him. He is one of my dear friends and brothers. The other thing you don't know, Reverend Stevens, Reverend Kim Gladney, Reverend Tony Johnson, myself, T.C. Caldwell, and others, we have established a Popeye's Chicken ministry. And we meet Tuesday, 1 o'clock at the Popeye's. Sister Stevens, if you can't find him, come on up to 63rd and Truth. Amen. Amen. Now, it's the Popeye's Chicken ministry because folk come in there and see us sitting there and they ask us for money. I'm going to talk about that in this sermon. And we don't give them money. We give them food. You hungry, bro, sit down right here. You'll get it on the way home. Don't worry about it. Do we have our text? Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were uneducated and untrained men, they marveled. And they realized that they had been with Jesus. And seeing the man who had been healed standing with them, they could say nothing against it. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they conferred amongst themselves, saying, "What shall we do to these men? For indeed that a notable miracle has been done through them is evident to all who dwell in Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. But that it spreads no further among the people, let us severely threaten them, that from now on they speak to no man in this name." So they called them and commanded them, are y'all with me? Not to speak at all, nor teach in the name of Donald J. Trump. All right, you try it again. So they commanded them not to speak at all nor teach in the name of Joe Biden. Your line is Jesus. So they commanded them not to speak at all in the name of Mayor Quentin Lucas. But Peter and John answered and said to them, "Whether it is right in the sight of God to listen to you more than to God, you judge. For we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." I want to talk to Park Avenue this morning about this thought. I just can't help it. I just can't help it. Listen. In the third chapter of John, there was a man who laid by the gate of the temple begging. Can I talk to someone? But how many of us here today know that there are some things money can't buy? Can I talk to anybody in Park Avenue? Money can buy you a mansion. Enough of it can. But it cannot buy you a home. Money can buy you a king-size bed with a Sealy Posturepedic mattress with a remote. I'm scared of y'all. But it cannot buy you rest. There are some things that money can't buy. As long as that man lay there and held his cup out, and we see him on the overpasses, and we run into him at Popeye's Chicken, they are asking for money. And guess what? They gave him what he asked for. But his condition never changed. Can I preach in this place? So one day, as God would have it, two broke preachers, me and Bowman, are coming to the temple. And we see him there, and he asks us for money. And we say to him, silver and gold have I none. That's what I ain't got. But can I share with you what I do? Listen, this ain't in my notes, but it's in my heart. And I know you don't do it at Park Avenue. But over there where I am, folk tell me all the time what they can't do. Reverend, I can't sing. Reverend, I can't usher. But I'm waiting for the list of what you can do. Can I talk to somebody? You can pick up that paper out of your seat when you get up. You can come to prayer meeting. And y'all gonna have to Google this one. We used to have BTU. We ain't got no money. But can we give you what? Such as we have. Come on, somebody. The word records that they reached down, pulled him by up, and immediately, I wish you'd read it in chapter 3. I ain't got time. It said he received his strength. And listen, when God has done something for you, this ain't in my sermon notes either, but I'm going to give you this one. You don't have to sit there like you're from the first church of the frigid air. I don't need nobody high-fiving 22 neighbors. I don't need no praise. I know what God read it, it's in chapter 3. It said he got up running, leaping, and praising God. Can I talk to somebody? Now, as we pick the narrative up here in chapter 4, it says that the haters. The haters. It's too hot. It's too cold. Haters. Service is too long. Service is too short. Haters. Did you see what she had on? Haters. No, I wasn't looking. It said they saw the boldness of Peter and John. And they started hating. Read it. They uneducated. Hater. That's what they do call names, Donald Trump. They're uneducated. They're untrained. But guess what? They've been with Jesus. Can't hate on that, can you? And so the haters decided. And watch what the haters had a meeting. We got to do something about this. I wish you would read this text. I'm just trying to unfold it for you. It said that they looked and saw that a notable miracle had been performed. Because that fellow that was laying there is standing. You'll get that on the way home too. And look, all the hating that they did, all the name calling that they did, all of the plotting, scheming, planning that they did, they could not deny that the miracle had been performed. It ain't in these notes, but it's in my heart. Can I say to you in 2024 that I still believe in? In miracles. I still believe God can open doors that have been closed. I still believe God can hand out a promotion on a job that I'm not necessarily qualified for. They could not deny. With all the hate, criticism, sarcasm, critique in their heart, they could not deny. I wish you would read that. They said that he was standing there and they could say nothing against it. But they reasoned and determined in their mind that they had to do something to stop it. So they have this meeting. They bring Peter and John to them. And they command them. That's a strong word in the Greek. Listen, fellas. Here's how this going to roll. Don't you speak. And watch what he companioned with speaking. Or teach. Because the devil don't want you to know nothing. The devil don't want you to come to Sunday school. Come on, get mad at me. The devil don't want you sitting up in Bible study, learning the books of the Bible and understanding. Don't teach. You heard the announcements of the various workshops and seminars that are coming. You watch the difference in the workshop and then watch the difference in Sunday morning. The devil don't want you equipped with the word of God. Come on in this house. And so we comically call the name. They said, don't speak, don't teach at all. We comically call the name of Donald Trump, Joe Biden, Mayor Lucas. But the truth of the matter is, there is no power in any other. In any other name. Than the name of Jesus. Can I suggest to you there's power in that name? Can I suggest to you that at the name of every knee must bow. 50 Cent must bow. Tech N9ne. Must bow. If you're old as me, Usher must bow at the name of Jesus. Every knee must bow, and every tongue must confess that he is Lord. Can I talk to you? And so Peter and John had their own meeting. And they said to their haters, we have nothing against what you've ordered us to do. But all we have is one problem. We've seen too much, and we've heard too much. And that's how I extracted my subject today. Yeah, I've seen too much, and I just can't help it. Sit there with your bougie self. I've seen my lights cut off. I've seen my water shut off. Listen, no harm, Bowman, but I had just brought my baby son home in the dead of winter, and I had been unemployed for several days. And the gas man knocked on the door and said, if you pay this amount, we'll leave it. I said, well, listen, sir, I didn't have it Monday. I didn't have it Tuesday. And a show enough, ain't got it Friday. Can I talk to someone? Now listen, I had asked church folk for some help and they gave me advice. They told me how I should save for a rainy day. Can I talk to somebody? But I did not need advice. I needed help. So the man took his gas key, Bowman, and went out to cut my gas off. And that key broke. $4.45 on a Friday, and he was unable to cut the gas off. And all I'm saying to you, I've seen too much. Can I talk to you? And I just can't help it. I've made myself a praise team of one. I've decided I'm gonna give God the glory and give God the praise. Anybody in here know we've been good? Say hey. Anybody in here know he'll pick you up? Say yeah. I want it. I want to do it. I'm going to mess with you. I want to do it. I can't help it, y'all. I can't help it. They say I'm too noisy, but I can't help it. They say I move around too much, but I can't help it. I've looked over my life. I've seen why. Woo! I'm through Park Avenue. I'm finished. I've completed expounding from the holy text. But I need to tell you that COVID-19 afflicted my body 30 plus days. I laid in the hospital in the COVID unit, hooked to tubes and wires. And can I say to youth who've never been sick, they make all hospital gowns the same way. There's no Gucci hospital gown. There's no Donna Karen hospital gown. They make them all the same way, backside out. And I'm laying there flat on my back with COVID in my body. And the last thing I saw was a sign that said, no one admitted beyond this point. Well, I'm here today to say to you, oh, I'm glad the Lord didn't read the sign. I came in my room. I healed my... Yes, sister, he thought I was worth saving. I'm sold out. Some of y'all ain't moved yet. But if you know he been good, get on. Can't help it. Y'all could have invited Reverend, Dr., Bishop, Apostle, anybody but me. You could have got somebody quiet. You could have got somebody who would lecture. But I made up my mind. Every time I stand, I'm going to give him glory. Every time I stand, I'm going to give him praise. Ain't he all right? Been through the storm and the rain. Y'all sit on out there here. I made it. Tried hard not to complain. I need three people over here to say, I made it. I'm trying to quit this, y'all. Ain't no secret what God can do. Come on, three people over here to say, he done it for others. He'll do it for you. I'm going to leave you alone, Park. Hallelujah. Thank God. I made it. Been sick as I could be. Any sick folk up in here? I made it. I told you I had COVID-19. Yeah, I made it. Hey.
no secret.
Somebody ought to just give him some glory in this.
Ain't no secret what God can do. He's done it for others. He'll do it for you.
I'm leaving you. Hallelujah. That's a praise, y'all. Hallelujah. Sit there and look at me. Hallelujah. Woo! Thank God. What happened, boy? I made it. All night, all day, doors are open, the angels keep it.
Open. Stand on your feet, please. You might encourage somebody sitting next to you. Is there one who would come to the Lord? One who would give their life unto Christ right now? In the presence of God and all these witnesses.